Hello my dear students and welcome back to my YouTube channel. In today's video lesson, I'll be discussing about how to calculate the effective nuclear charge of an electron. Now to do this is very easy, we just need to know a formula. Now this is it. Effective nuclear charge is given as Z minus S. Now the question we ask ourselves, what is Z and what is S? Now Z simply means the atomic number. Z simply means the atomic number, or you say the number of protons. Okay? Z simply means atomic number or numbers of protons. And what is S? S simply means the number of core electrons. The number of core electron. Now, this is the formula we use to solve the effective nuclear charge of an electron. Now, let's take an example giving sodium atom. This is sodium atom. And we all know that sodium has the atomic number to be 11 and the mass number to be 23. Okay, now this is a sodium nuclide. Now we asked to calculate the effective nuclear charge of sodium. Now you can see we now know that the Z, which is the atomic number or proton number, is 11, because this is the atomic number 11. Now how do we calculate, or how do we determine the numbers of core electrons? It's simply by drawing the electronic configuration of sodium. Now this is it. This is the nucleus of sodium, okay? And this is the first energy level, also called the K shell. You know, the first energy level contains two electrons. So this is one electron and this is another electron. Meanwhile, the next energy level is the hell shell, containing eight electrons, okay? It contains eight electrons. Now, our sole aim is to get 11. As the number. So lastly, we draw the last shell by just putting in one electron. So when we calculate, you see we get 11 electrons, because here is 1 and here is 8, okay, and here is 2. So it gives us 11. Now this is basically the electronic configuration of sodium atom, whereby to determine the number of core electrons is simply getting core electron. Simply means the innermost electron, because the last energy level, electrons in the last energy level are called the valence electron. Now to determine the numbers of core electron, we simply just take or calculate the numbers of electron before the valence electron. Now you can see here that the valence electron for sodium here is just 1. Now what are the electrons below this last shell? We calculate it. So here is 2, 2, 2, 2, that's 8 plus 2, it gives us 10. So it means that the value for S is 10. Okay, the value for S, which is the number of core electrons, is 10, because I said earlier that to get our numbers of core electrons, you just take the numbers of electron before the valence electron, that's the last shell. Okay, so you can see when we calculate, we get 10 electrons. So to get our effective nuclear charge of sodium is simply Z minus S. So what is Z? 11 minus S, which is what? 10. So 11 minus 10 is plus 1. So you can see the effective nuclear charge of sodium is plus 1. Now taking another example using sodium ion, okay? You know, sodium ion is positively charged. You know, sodium is positively charged. It's a metal. So sodium ion, same as 23, 11. Now, to determine the effective nuclear charge of this nuclide, because the value for the effective nuclear charge for this nuclide and for this will be different. Now, you can see here that the proton number here, the proton number is 11. We all said the proton number is same as the atomic number. Okay, so the proton number is 11, same as atomic number Z. Okay, now you can see now to draw the electronic configuration of this sodium ion, it will be different from this because this one has a positive one charge. So to the total number of electrons for this nucleus is solved as proton number minus the charge. Now what is the proton number? 11 minus plus 1, so we get 10 electrons, because it's our electron number that we use to determine this shell notation. Now let's draw the shell notation for sodium ion, because it's the electron number that determines how many electrons will be drawn. Now look at it. This is the nucleus containing the first energy level, and the first energy level or the K shell contains 2 electrons. Our sole aim is to get 10 electrons. Now here will be 2, 2, 2, 2, because this other shell carries a maximum number of electrons to be 8 electrons. Now 8 plus 2, it gives us 10 electrons. Now you can see the value for Z is 11. Now what is the S value, which is numbers of core electrons? Because to get our effective nuclear charge, we need to determine the value for Z, which is the atomic number or proton number, and the value for S, which is the core electron, the numbers of core electron. Now what is the numbers of core electron for this sodium ion? Now it is positively charged. It is simply this. I said to determine your number of core electron in an atom, you simply just get the numbers of electron before the valence electron. Now you can see the valence electron here was 1. So how many electrons are before this? Last shell, they are 10. That's why we use 10. But for this one now, you can see the valence electron, this one has only 2 shells, and the valence electrons here, they are 8. So the electrons before the valence electron is the core electron. So you can see the number of core electron here will be 2, because there are 2 electrons before the valence electron and the valence shell. So it's simply S will be equal to 2. Now what will be the effective nuclear charge of this sodium ion? ZEFF is equal to Z minus S, whereby Z is 11 minus 2, which is equal to plus 9. Now you can see here that to calculate the effective nuclear charge is very easy. Now I believe you now understand about the concept on how to calculate the effective nuclear charge. Thanks for watching.